No. Not at all.
Thank you so much. Ladies and gentlemen, once again, your WRAP players.
Oh, what a ghastly meeting.
You didn't give in to her?
Indeed not. I made it very clear I have no intention of being strangled by her purse strings.
Oh, Henry, I'm proud of you.
I had a most unchristian impulse to take those blueprints and give her a good whack over her mink coat.
I beg your pardon, Bishop?
Yes, Miss Castlewood?
Mr. Trevor's on the phone. Tell him the bishop will call him back, please, after dinner.
Yes, Mrs. Bro.
Henry, what's happened to you? To us? To our marriage?
That's a strange question to ask.
No. We used to be so happy. We used to make other people happy. Henry, that was your gift. You're no financier. You're no promoter. Kowtowing to people, flattering them, begging them.
It's got to be done, Julia. I want this cathedral to stand like a great beacon. I want its light to shine. I want it.
Yes. Yes, Henry. Oh, here's a contribution I collected.
Oh? What is it?
It's an old Roman coin from Professor Witheridge.
Well, what does he think I can do with it?
Well, it's beginning. Now all you need is just another $4 million.
Julia, don't be flippant about this. Well, if dinner's ready, let's have it over with. I have a lot of work to do tonight. Yes, Mr. Trevor. Very well, Mr. Trevor. I'll be there. 10:30 tomorrow morning. Good night. You may as well go home now, Miss Castlewood.
But there's still a great deal of work to do, sir.
You're a secretary, not a machine. Now run along.
Thank you. Oh, and don't forget, you have a speech to make tomorrow at the Junior Assembly.
Oh, no. What time?
It's a luncheon meeting. 1 o'clock. Good night, Bishop.
Good night, Miss Castlewood. Oh, God. What am I to do? Can't you help me? Can't you tell me? Oh, God, please. Please help me.
Magnificent.
Henry, do you believe I am what I say I am?
Well, how can I? I have nothing but your word for it.
But you are a bishop. You, of all people, can trust the word of the angel.
Well, what do you propose to do? Perform a miracle?
If necessary.
Well, why don't you? Why don't you create a cathedral with the wave of your hand?
Oh, no, no, no. You wouldn't want me to do that, would you? How would you explain it?
Well, I...
Henry, is anything wrong? Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't know you had a caller.
Oh, how have you been, Julia? I'm Dudley. Henry is engaging me to help him this week with his work.
You mean you're going to be his assistant?
That's it, exactly. I'm going to try to help Henry to get some relaxation.
Oh, that's what I've been praying for.
Oh, you too.
Henry, I'm so relieved, dear. Where did you come from, Dudley?
Oh, all around.
Julia, this man claims that he's an A.
I've been doing some social work downtown.
Julia, if you don't mind, I must talk to this gentleman alone.
We were just having dinner, Dudley. Won't you join us?
Well, that's very kind of you, but I really must go. I'll see you both in the morning.
In the morning?
Oh, yes, bright and early.
I'll wait in the dining room, Henry. Good night.
Oh, good night, Julia.
Are you sure you're an angel?
Oh, I know. It isn't easy, Henry, but you've just got to take me on faith.
Yes, or for how long? How long will it take?
Until you can utter another prayer and say that you have no further need of me. That I've begun and forgotten. And Julia's waiting, Henry.
Yes, I know. But I still don't understand. Dudley? Dudley, where are you? Dudley?
Well, that man in there, oh, I can't explain it.
You needn't try, Henry.
Oh, but you mustn't think that I...
This is the way it is. This is the way it's always going to be. Well, I'll tell Matilda she can have a day off for Christmas shopping. I'll take care of Debbie. I'll see you at dinner, Henry.
What are you doing, Dudley?
I'm just looking through your files, Henry. Well, I see that Mrs. Hamilton has pledged $1 million to the Cathedral Fund, but she hasn't sent her check.
Never mind that file. That's work for a bookkeeper, not an aide. Work for a bookkeeper!
Well, so you're beginning to believe in me.
I don't know who you are. I don't know where you came from or who sent you. I only wish you made haste.
Because the cathedral must be built.
Obviously, that's the most important thing.
Or because Julia must be happy. It's going to be difficult to help you, Henry, unless I'm sure of what it is that you really want.
Yes, well, I'm afraid you'll have to excuse me. Mr. Trevor likes punctuality.
Well, run along, Henry. This file's in an awful mess. I think I'll reorganize it.
I still think you're wasting your time on unimportant details.
Oh, nothing's unimportant, Henry. Remember, we're interested in even the lowliest sparrow. System of rearranging card files.
Do it again.
Some other time.
You're Dudley, aren't you? Mommy told me. Mommy says you're very nice.
Well, that's extremely kind of Mommy.
She said that maybe with you here, maybe we'll get to see Daddy once in a while.
Yes, maybe we will.
Debbie, that'll be enough out of you, dear. Come along.
Yes, Mommy.
Oh, so you're going out?
To the park. I'm going to go play in the snow. Goodbye, Dudley.
Goodbye, Debbie. Have a good time.
Thank you.
have memories of this place, haven't you?
Yes. As a matter of fact, it was in this restaurant that Henry asked me to marry him.
Yes, I know.
You know?
I know how you must feel. There's a fortune teller over there. You care to have your palm read?
No, thank you. Would you?
Oh, I know too much about myself as it is.
And I know so little about myself.
Oh, really? May I look at your hand?
You can tell fortunes, too.
It's not too difficult.
Well, what do you see?
I never noticed, Julia. Your eyes are green. I see a great deal of happiness. I see a woman who's adored. I see a rich, full life.
Do you see Henry's new cathedral?
No. No, I don't.
And Debbie?
Oh, no need to worry about her. She'll be like you, Julia. She'll have youth and beauty, no matter how old she lives to be.
People do grow old.
No, not everybody. Only those who were born old to begin with. You, Julia, were born young. You'll remain that way.
I wish I could believe you.
You may.
You haven't looked at my hand once. I simply don't know what to think of you, Dudley. Whether you're serious or joking.
Well, I'm at my most serious when I am joking.
Well, then maybe you should... Oh, no.
Well?
That table over there. No, no, don't look. Three ladies, all in the cathedral committee. They're simply glaring at me.
Really? Or glare back?
They saw you holding my hand.
Oh. Well, then, if you'll excuse me, I'd better do something about it, hadn't I? Inspire you?
Why, that's the coin you gave to Henry. professor?
Yes, I borrowed it from Henry's desk.
You wasted your time. It's worthless.
Oh, on the contrary. This coin is one of the rarest of all antiquities. Only 100 of these coins were minted by Julius Caesar 2,000 years ago. That was when Cleopatra visited Rome. Presumably, these coins were used to pay her hotel bill.
Yeah, that's amazing.
Well, nobody knew about it except Caesar's wife, and she had the coins destroyed. But this one she overlooked. It's an unwritten chapter in history, and you, Professor, will write it.
Do you know any more stories like that?
Oh, any number of them.
Well, you're a curious fellow, Professor.
Have you just begun to notice that?
Where do you come from?
Well, what if I told you that I come from another planet? Would you believe me?
No, no.
I believe you, Dudley.
And you'd be right, Julia, as always. We all come from our own little planets. That's why we're all different. That's what makes life interesting.
Oh, it's getting late. I must be leaving, really.
Sorry, Professor.
If my wine bottle wasn't empty, we could say goodbye with another drink.
Empty?
Yes, I have barely enough for the bottle. It's half full.
Oh, save it for next time, Professor.
I'm getting old, but I can't see what's inside of one.
Yes, my friend?
There's one thing that troubles me greatly.
Well?
Writing history is a tremendous task. I wonder, will I have time to finish it?
You'll finish it. You'll have time.
I don't know why I ask you that question. How would you know? But somehow I believe you. You see, for quite a while now, every time I passed the cemetery, I felt as if I were a part of it.
Goodbye, Professor. Come and see us, please.
I will. Goodbye. God bless you both.
I'll pass that recommendation along. Thank you, Professor.
Why, thank you.
I'm proud of you. I'm proud.
proud of the well-ordered life we lead, and I want you to know that I think the credit for that is due to you much more than to me.
Thank you again, dear.
Do you think I'm an excellent husband?
Of course, dear. Henry, I hope you're going to take things a little easier now. I mean, with Dudley here, he's very able.
You do?
Yes. He knows so many things.
What, for instance?
Well, you should have seen him this afternoon. We met Professor Witheridge. Why, Dudley knows more about history than he does.
You sure he's been at it longer?
What?
Nothing. I'll drop in to see Debbie now, dear.
Thank you, Dudley. You're welcome, Henry.
certainly a pleasure.
Thank you. The bishop will try to get here later, Mr. Miller. Something important came up.
Oh, of course. He's such a busy man now.
We didn't want to delay rehearsal.
Mrs. Brougham, I'm terribly embarrassed. Look over there. Only two of the boys have come. It's just too difficult. I suppose trying to compete with basketball and Christmas.
Oh, I wouldn't worry, Mr. Miller. They'll all show up. Hiya, boys.
Hi.
What do you sing?
Me? First soprano.
Any good?
I got it.
Well, I'm not giving up.
You mean alone?
Well, you've got Rupert with you. Hi, Rupert.
Hi.
Well, what do you say?
Well, it's okay by me.
Fine. I'll start you off at the organ. Well, I suppose he's detained at Mrs. Hamilton's.
Oh, of course. You know, Dudley, it's a strange thing. You seem to be able to make me feel that everything's going to be all right.
Everything could be all right for everyone, Julia. If people would only learn to behave as human beings.
It's a lovely night, isn't it? Oh, driver, could you take us through the park, please?
That's out of your way, lady.
You getting bored with us, driver?
Say, I'll draw you my way in Mexico City if you want me to. That's the trouble with this country. Too many people who don't know where they're going. They want to get there too fast. I'd call you two very unusual people.
Oh, thank you. You're very perceptive.
You know your destination, but you're in no hurry to get there. And you're not reluctant to invest an extra 4 bits with a detour of nature.
I'm afraid that's no prayer.
It was right from the heart. I want you to go.
Julia doesn't.
Julia? Get out! Get out!
Julia is about to come down those stairs. Don't let her see you like this, Henry. Try to calm yourself.
Dudley?
He's gone.
Oh, Debbie's away. She wants to say goodnight to him.
I just told you Dudley is gone.
But where?
How should I know?
But why did he leave so suddenly?
Because I got rid of him. I told him to go away. I fired him.
Why?
Because he's incompetent. He's no good at his job, and I cannot stand the sight of him.
Henry!
Believe me, Julia, I know what I'm doing.
Days have passed since Dudley disappeared, much to the relief of Bishop Henry Rome, and now it's early evening on Christmas Eve.
Here's a list of your calls, Bishop, ending at Mrs. Hamilton's. Oh, and there's a taxi waiting for you outside.
Thank you, Miss Castaway. If you're through typing my sermon before I'm back, just leave your copies on my desk.
Yes, sir.
I'm sorry to keep you so late on Christmas Eve.
It's all right, sir. Bishop Rome?
Yes?
There's still no word from Mr. Dudley.
Miss Castaway? I discharged Mr. Dudley. There's no reason at all to hear from him.
Yes, sir.
Now, if you don't mind, please tell Mrs. Brougham that the taxi is waiting.
Thank you.
Whom did you say is calling, sir?
Oh, I'm Dudley Stevens, Bishop Rome's new assistant. Would you mind telling Mrs. Hamilton I'm here?
I don't believe she's expecting you, sir.
Oh, I'm sure she isn't.
Yes, sir.
I'll wait in the music room.
The music room, sir?
Yes, there's a harp in there. I wonder if she'd mind if I...
Oh, I'm afraid she would, sir.
Oh, well, in that event, you'd better hurry off and tell her.
Yes, sir, I shall.
Now you see what Dudley's done, Henry.
Yes, I see.
And you understand.
Mrs. Hamilton, Julia, forgive me, but I have to leave. There's someone I must see immediately.
Henry?
Henry, my dear fellow, sit down, sit down.
Professor Wetheridge, I just had to see you.
I'm delighted. Here, Henry. Glass of sherry.
Oh, no, thank you.
Oh, but I insist. Can you see this bottle? Now watch. I filled two glasses. Behold, the bottle is still half full. And what's more, the sherry itself, it stimulates, it warms, it inspires, but no matter how much you drink, it never inebriates. And the contents never diminish. Always half full.
Dougie's been here?
Yes. And that bottle doesn't know. He told me to look up some ancient text in the library, which no living scholar has ever been able to decipher. I read them as if they were English. Let's face it, Henry. This Dougie fellow is not like the rest of us.
He says he's an angel.
An angel?
That's funny. Nothing stopped me from saying it that time. Angel. He says he's an angel.
From heaven?
That I'm not so sure about.
An angel. It's too bad. He's such a nice man.
Oh, he's brought nothing but disaster to me.
That's absurd. He and Julia were here the other day. She seemed happier than I've seen her in years.
He's made her despise me.
Are you sure?
That's why I've come to see you. Do you think it's all my own fault, Professor? You don't have to answer. I answer this in more ways than one. I suppose that Dougie came to me just to confirm that I already lost Julia's love.
If there's anything I can do, Henry.
There's nothing anyone can do.
Well, there must be. You and Julia love each other. You always have.
It's only partly true. I love Julia.
Well, then why don't you fight for her?
Fight? How can I fight against them?
You have tremendous advantage over him.
Advantage? Over an angel?
Precisely. He is an angel. Julia is a creature of God. She is a woman, and you are a man.
Yes, I am.
And if I were you, I'd get myself home and I...
Home? Oh, that's where he'll be, waiting for Julia. Excuse me, happy Christmas.
I'm going.
I said that as fact when I see it.
Oh, no, you won't. Because when I'm gone, you will never know that an angel visited this house.
And Julia? What about her?
No, there will be no memory with her either. Or with Debbie, or with the professor, or anyone else.
Oh, I don't trust you.
You may, because your prayer has been answered.
That's not true. I prayed for a cathedral.
No. No, Henry. You prayed for guidance, and that's been given to you.
Darling.
I'm being paged. Just a minute, please. Goodbye, Henry.
If we should need you again, will you come back?
Not I. I'm requesting an assignment at the other end of the universe.
Is that because I was so difficult?
No. This difficulty was in me. When an immortal finds himself envying the mortal trusted to his care, it's a definite signal of danger.
Darling. Yes,
I heard you the first time. Now go upstairs. Take her in your arms, Henry. And kiss her for me. You lucky Henry.
Julia? Julia!
Quiet, darling. You'll wake up Debbie.
Are you all right?
Why, yes, of course I am. Henry, did you get that for Debbie?
Yeah, what for Debbie?
That little angel on her bed.
Why, no.
I can't imagine where it came from. Henry, what is it?
I don't know. I have the most inexplicable feeling of happiness.
Well, so do I.
Oh, Julia. I love you, Julia.
I love you, Henry. Listen, the bell's from St. Timothy's.
It's almost midnight.
You'll have to hurry.
Oh, my sermon! It was all about the cathedral. I'll never do now.
Don't worry, dear. You'll think of something. Something even better. Merry Christmas, Henry.
Merry Christmas, darling. Tonight, I want to tell you the story of an empty stocking. Once upon a midnight clear, there was a child's cry. A blazing star hung over a stable, and wise men came with birthday gifts. We have forgotten many things through the centuries, but not that night. We celebrated with stars on Christmas trees, with the sound of bells, and with gifts. Especially with gifts. You give me a book, I give you a tie. Aunt Martha has always wanted an orange squeezer, and Uncle Harry, we do with a new pipe. Oh, we forget about nobody, adult or child. All the stockings are filled, all that is, except one. And we even forgotten to hang it up. The stocking for the child born in a manger. It is his birthday we're celebrating. Don't let us ever forget that. Let us ask ourselves what he would wish for most, and then let each put in his share. Loving kindness, warm hearts, and a stretched out hand of tolerance. All the shining gifts to make a peace on earth.
We will see you again in 2018 for our shows in April, August, and December. So mark your calendars and check the library's website. And as always, we thank you for your time, this time. Until next time, this is WRAP signing off.